29th of March 2018.
I only got very little battery, so that'll be brief. Okay, come start. Now, this 15-year-old male, entire golden, not golden retriever, Labrador retriever, came in 1 month ago for the leg amputation due to the fact that he had a big swelling here on the tibia. This is a tibia. The tibia. And this swelling was for how long? It was a big swelling of the bone. Two months only? Okay, so we had an x-ray done, and you can see from here, show the x-ray to be. You see from here that the x-ray will show that the swelling was really very big. This is the 1/3 of the right tibia. This is the lower leg. This is the tibia, and you can see it's cancerous because the bones break down there. The fibula bone has broken down. The tibia bone also breaks down. And that's why there's a big swelling there. I think it's more than 2 months because the dog is very thin. Right now. So it's been going on for some time. Now the thing is the right lower tibia swelling emaciated, weight loss over 1 year. So the diagnosis was bone tumor, so the treatment actually is to amputate below the knee, this is the knee, amputate and so as to prevent the tumors from spreading up to the other legs and to the body. Now we had the x-ray of the lungs to see whether there's any nodules on it. There are actually, you see, normally sometimes the bone cancer is spread to the lung. There are a few, actually quite noticeable, do you zoom in? Quite noticeable nodules, but the dog is still looks okay, doesn't have this coughing, no coughing, right? Slight coughing. But other than that, the lung actually is quite clear, you see, it's very black. Show that the lung is clear, there's no pneumonia. The heart also is good, and you can see the heart. The heart is good. And so these are the two views. They didn't take the other view. They took two views on here, right? So the two views, there should be a central dorsal view where you can see the upside down. You can see the left and right lungs, but now you can't see. Okay, so now the owner came in. Actually, what is your main complaint? It's the swelling, right? There's some swelling here.
There's some swelling.
According to her, there's a swelling there.
Trembling.
The trembling there, twitching, right? See, there's a disadvantage of wearing this. You see, there's another pressure saw, you know, from this. No, this one. So this one is not padded. It's not padded, so when the dog walks,
this
one
is also padded.
He feels the pain. This is a neighbor walk, he doesn't want to walk anymore. So now we discover that this one is okay when a dog is able to walk on four legs. Yeah.
You see
the hair loss. And then normally the hair should be full up to here because of the friction. I'm sure the other side had the same problem. But anyway, this explains why the dog doesn't want to walk too long. Now you see the muscles. The muscles are almost, there's some sensitivity, you see. That explains for the twitching. She was talking about the twitching. Okay, there's some sensitivity here. Maybe on reflection, it could be due to this friction for this harness. So it's constantly putting pressure. There's a big nerve here, the brachial nerve. It probably compresses the nerve when the owner pulls the harness up. And it compresses the nerve and make it very sensitive. In fact, the owner did send me a video of the twitching when the dog. It twitches for how long? It twitches for how long? Few seconds or few minutes?
2 minutes.
And there was some twitching even before that, also, right? Before the surgery.
I thought it was painful.
Yeah, pain is one of the reasons. Now, you see this is the scar here, there. Stitches have been removed. The stitches are very good, they can still last for 1 month. Now, according to the owner, there's a lung here, but actually it's not. This is part of the loose skin, and this is part of the stump, the muscle stump, because when you operate, you cut part of the muscles and cut a little stump. Now here's the pressure saw again from the harness again. Yeah, this is getting to be red now. So we have a quick check on the heart. Heart is okay on the right side. Lungs is okay. There's no harsh sound. Now, are you sure there's no cough? There's some coughing?
No.
Oh, there's no coughing. It's all right now. Oh, now we see the gums. Now, these gums shows that the dog really has good food. It's not pale. I think last time it was pale, right?
Yeah.
So I think he might affect him a lot of liver. Do you feed a lot of liver or something which causes the gum to be pink? And it's not dehydrated. And you can see the ribs are not so obvious. You see the earlier video. See, almost coming up. So now the problem is the dog needs to be exercised. Maybe just a towel over here. Let's spread the towel instead of having this. Because of the pressure sores.
This one also
No, the towel will be up from here to here.
Oh, I see.
It's like a suspension.
I see. Okay.
And then one person will walk the dog. Okay. As much as she can. He can.
Okay.
Then I was talking to you about the teeth, right? But I guess it's too old. The teeth is bad now. The interesting thing about this case is the blood test shows there was an infection. Before operation, there was infection. You see the blood test before operation there? Bacteremia. That was February 19. Operation was when? 18. You can see the white cell count was high. Neutrophils also high. You see there? 79% and 27.3. Normal is 6 to 17. That was before the operation. After the operation, there's no more. The total white cell count is normal. So this is the video of the operation. Anyway, it is separate. Yeah. Okay, so that's so what do you want to ask me? Nothing really. Actually, shivering is the pressure. Now I see that it's a pressure from this. There's a big nerve there.
But he don't wear 24/7. When he finish his work, he I don't know.
But the shivering was there before that also. Right? Before operation. But lasted 10 minutes. Actually, the same shivering.
Yeah.
The same thing?
Yes.
When the dog lies down?
Yeah.
Both sides?
Yeah.
10 minutes?
Yeah, about.
10 minutes is a long time, you know?
Mm.
Or when the dog is sleeping, right?
Yeah, he like lie down, sleeping.
It is.
You can.
When he's asleep or is he sleeping?
Sleep. Sleep or awake? I mean, they quite
okay, sleep. Okay, he's quite sensitive, yeah. Let's check on lymph nodes. Okay, well, I don't have any enlarged lymph nodes.
I thought it's pain.
Well, this one is enlarged. A bit enlarged. Yeah. Is it eating by himself?
Yeah.
It's got sore throat. How come?
Vomited just now.
Yeah.
Why
would you have sore throat unless it's getting infection? So we'll do a blood test again, just to check on overall the liver, kidney. And other than that, it should be okay.
But this swelling, shiver?
Shiver,
trembling. Is it pain? I think it's pain.
Painful, yeah, some pain.
Just painkiller, on and off.
But it's not every day, right? Is it every day?
Yesterday, the day before, today.
Yeah, there's some pain here. Yeah. There's some. It's quite sensitive. Normally dogs don't feel any pain when I touch them. It's still skinny. Yeah, quite sensitive. For some reason, it's hypersensitive.
He got fit.
Huh? He had fit before?
Yeah. He...
So those shivering will be just the sign of early fit, huh? He had fit before, right?
Yes.
The whole body shivers, right?
Fit.
Also, that will explain.
4-5 times throughout, lah.
Mm. The ears are very dirty, so you didn't clean the ears. You really have to clean it, it's so dirty. And this could be causing pain also.
Oh, I see.
I'm surprised you didn't feel any pain. All this should be washed.
It just came back, you know. Come back by itself.
We're going to give you the ear drops, but it's inside, deep in.
Yeah.
To flush the ears, you know, to flush.
Can you clean for me?
Okay, can. Okay, finish up.